السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We always praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more so on an occasion like this. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them and to bless every one of us, to grant us goodness in this world and the next. My brothers, my sisters, we are about to witness the officiation of a marriage known as nikah in the Arabic language. It is a moment of excitement, mashallah, tabarakallah. It is a moment of happiness. It is a moment of gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is also a moment of reflection for every single one of us. And it brings about the greatest of the qualities of a believer. Whenever we witness something good that any one of us has achieved or is going through, it is part of the duty of a mu'min to be happy for them. Hence, mashallah, we appreciate such a beautiful gathering, so many people who witness such a lovely occasion to display their happiness and solidarity. In the same way, when a person goes through a sad moment, a loss of any sort, it is our duty as believers to say a word of comfort to them, to reach out to them in a way that we show we are part of a broader family in spite of some minor differences we may have in our day-to-day lives. It is only natural and normal that we would think differently. Our likes and dislikes may be slightly different, but in a nutshell, we are brothers and sisters in faith and we care for each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all goodness, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless not only this occasion, but every occasion of goodness and happiness in our lives, and may Allah grant us increase in those occasions. Ameen. My brothers and sisters, when I say it is a moment of gratitude, firstly, the bride and the groom coming together today, they should be showing this gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by ensuring that nothing haram happens on a day like this. Many of us, in our excitement, we tend to forget that it's Allah who gave us this moment of excitement. He gave us the moment of happiness. In such a moment of happiness, we tend to become so forgetful that we start doing things that are unacceptable in the rules and regulations laid down by the same Allah. So it's a moment of reflection. It's a moment of showing gratitude by obeying Allah. If a person has only obeyed Allah on this day, trust me, it is enough to have shown the minimum gratitude to Allah. Thereafter, you know, one may decide to engage in extra dua and adhkar. All that is permissible. There is no limit to it, and there is nothing fixed to actually do on a day of this nature besides your own worshipping of Allah, perhaps on a voluntary basis through dua, adhkar, etc. Perhaps salah, if one wants to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through nafila, etc. It is possible and it is there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. So I was saying the couple needs to bear in mind the gratitude that they show to Allah. Similarly, the way they chart the path ahead should be in line with what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way they decide to live their lives should be also in line with what Allah has permitted. You and I know that intimacy is permissible in Islam upon marriage, but there are certain things that are prohibited even within that. We need to learn this, we need to understand it, and we need to be very, very careful about the rules and regulations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has laid down. May Allah make it easy for us. Similarly, the families of those who are coming together today, there should be an element of happiness, gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not easy to marry, nor is it easy to get someone married. Especially in this day and age where we're living with such materialism that people actually sway from side to side, forgetting what Allah has instructed in favor of materialism, that would be a loss. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a deep understanding, to make us from those who don't compromise our faith for a dollar or a pound or a dirham or a dinar or gold or silver, but rather we obey the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So gratitude even with the families.
Similarly, it is a day of reflection for every one of us. Hence, it is made a sunnah. The Prophet ﷺ tells us that we should try to attend. In fact, when it comes to the function of the nikah, it is a sunnah to participate, to witness, in order for us to learn a lesson. Just like with the janazah, there is a different type of a reward. In fact, with the janazah, there is a greater reward, because that is a reality. The hadith says, if you participate in the janazah salah, you get a mountain of reward. And if you go ahead to actually help with the burial, or participate in it, or witness it, you get two mountains of reward. The idea is none other than a reflection over your own condition. I'm supposed to be thinking, who am I? And who's this person who's just passed away? Where have they gone? Where am I going? What have they done? What am I doing? I'm still alive, but I'm heading there any moment. So in a similar manner, when people are getting married and we get to witness this beautiful occasion, we should ponder over our condition. Are we married? If the answer is no, ya ma'ashara shabab, man istata'a minkum al-ba'ata falyatazawwaj. O youth, whoever is able and capable. This capacity and capability is physical as well as financial, mental, etc. If you're able and capable, don't delay in getting married. Start looking for a spouse, get married. You will fulfill such a great act of worship, because now you're tested. You know, when you're growing up and you're taught character and conduct, the first time you actually get to display that character and conduct at close range is with your own spouse. There will be a few differences in the way you think, like I said earlier, on a broader level, but even on a smaller level, your likes and dislikes might be slightly different. There may be a few differences here or there. How you manage these differences, you have a time and a moment to display the character and conduct that you have within you. Hence, you become a better person. The Prophet ﷺ says, خيَارُكُمْ أو خيرُكُمْ خيرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. The best from amongst you are those who are best to their wives, their family members. If your family members can guarantee, or they say, this is a good man, you're a good man, we don't need to ask anyone else. Well, that's if they say it in your absence. If they say it in your presence, one wonders whether it's just the gun they worried about, or if they're actually meaning it. But in actual fact, if your spouse can say, wonderful man, great person, your family members can bear witness, this person is absolutely a gem, then you're a gem. May Allah make us from amongst those. Because they see you 24/7, happy, sad, hungry, full, wealthy, no wealth, good day, bad day. How do you display your character? Are you still smiling, speaking with respect, etc., etc.? So this is something that we need to think about. Ponder over it. It's a challenge. All of us seated here, if we're not married, we need to try and make sure that we start looking for a spouse. If we are married, we need to ask ourselves, we've all passed through a day like this, right? We all got married. Those who are married, there was a day when you did get married. How excited were you? How happy were you? Some people are so excited they don't even know what to say. I remember once I was officiating and I asked the young man the question, you know, the ijab and qabul, you have the proposal and the acceptance. So I said, so and so, you know, has proposed to marry you, or they are offering their daughter in marriage to you, etc., etc. Have you accepted her? So he says, yeah. So I thought, while yeah is an okay answer, because it's colloquial, I said, let's formalize it. So I said, say yes, I do. I said, say yes, I do. You know what the young boy says? Yes, you do. I did not mean you. That was depicting of the excitement of the moment. That's how excited some people were. So excited they don't even know what they're saying. But I guess we were excited. The question is, how excited are you today? 5 years down the line, 10 years, 20 years down the line. Are you excited? Are you equally excited? Are you happier than that day? If you are, and there are cases of that, mashallah, we say nurun ala nur. You're, I think, one in a million, mashallah. And if this country has a population of 13 million, there are only 13 people like that. But on a more serious note, we need to strive towards becoming happier than the day we actually officiated the nikah. Secondly, if you are equally happy, similar, mashallah, you're doing well. If you're not, which is the case of a lot of people, go back on an occasion like this and ask yourself, why? spend a moment trying to resolve matters, solve your problems, go back, make promises. I'm going to go back, I'm going to make sure that I address my wife or my husband with utmost respect, my family members, etc. This is a time of pondering. This is why we say an officiation of nikah is actually a time of reflection over your own condition. Some who might have lost their spouses through perhaps becoming widowed or divorce. It's not the end of the world. You try again, and there is no limit to the trial. A day will come when you will be so happy you would not have actually regretted trying. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us happiness. In life, success might not come upon the first try, even at school, even in your business. But the one who gives up is the real loser. It's not about how much you made or how successful you were first time. It's about whether you gave up or not. If you did not give up, even if you're not making ends meet, you're a successful person based on the fact that you didn't give up. Life is not about giving up. The same applies in marriage. You don't give up, you try, you keep trying. Yes, if it becomes totally toxic, then subhanAllah, there are other steps that can be taken in order to protect both parties. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never let us see such a day. And if people have seen such a day, may Allah make it easy for them. So my brothers and sisters, these were a few words that I thought I'd share with you on this beautiful occasion. MashaAllah, like I say, we're very happy for the couple coming together. MashaAllah, the families of those coming together, as well as all those who have participated and attended to witness here this evening. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all happiness and goodness. May Allah forgive our shortcomings and our sins. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability not only to show gratitude, but to reflect over our own condition. It's never too late. It's never too late. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. I want to end off by making mention of one good request that I have. Usually, when people get married, you know, those near and dear start asking themselves, what should we give the couple? It's a question, right? Some people on their cards, they would write there, no boxed gifts, which means cash only. You know, sometimes they might write USD, no bond notes, you know. They might have an eco cash number in Zimbabwe. May Allah protect us. All that aside, the biggest gift you can ever give people who are coming together in marriage is a dua. Trust me, it's a prayer. Barakallahu lakuma wa baraka alaykuma wa jama'a baynakuma fi khayr. We ask Allah to bless you, to bless everything that comes out of this union, and may Allah unite you with such blessings and barakah that you will see happiness and bliss throughout this world and into the next. What a great gift. We don't need to actually sometimes give material gifts. It just needs to be a good dua, a happy moment, a lovely word, and that's enough. That's actually so beautiful. If that is accepted by Allah, trust me, you've done the couple a huge favor. So that is the dua that inshallah we make for the couple. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama ala nabina Muhammad.